Hey guys, it's your boy Ian. I'm back here with another like no BS Starfield update. So it's been a while since I last talked to you guys. I really was gonna try to go into like the deep dive element of the Starfield Direct, and I kind of realized that was just like over and done with. We all really kind of got like what it is out of like the Direct. It was pretty straightforward. There's a lot of Easter eggs, a lot of teaser stuff in there, but what I really want to talk about is just, we're 29 days away from the early release of Starfield, and there are some really cool things happening as of recent. So let's start with the first thing we're talking about today, and that's going to be the Gamescom event that's happening in Cologne, Germany, August 28th, so a few days before the release. They're going to be doing some, like all the big Xbox executives are going to be there. You know, the GM of marketing, Aaron Greenberg, more than likely Phil Spencer, even Todd Howard might do a guest appearance. But it looks like he's like just like head in the sand, grinding away at getting this game out the door and in the hands of some loyal fans. But what will be happening at Gamescom is the Starfield Theater Experience. No one knows what it is. There's been no details about it. Some people think it's going to be Starfield Direct again in theaters. I saw it in theaters thanks to Xbox Fan Fest giving out those tickets. So I highly doubt that it's going to be that in theaters again. I think there's going to be like some gameplay footage exclusively shown at Gamescom in this 4K-esque like, surround sound theater. So I think it's going to be more something like that. Another thing, too, is Starfield Photo Opportunities. They might bring out Vasco, the big robot, long arms. So Bethesda Game Studios had commissioned a robot to be built over a year ago. It looks really, really cool, real realistic. And I think that might be added thing. I think there might be some Bethesda Game Studios developers, just doing, photo opportunities with fans and stuff like that. And I think there actually might be, like, some more like marketing-esque type promotion activation stuff going on. So, dudes dressed up like the New Frontier, main character default guy. So maybe a guy in astronaut suit, Vasco, maybe some UC guys, maybe some, Free Star Collective folks, maybe some, maybe like those types of folks in the game, some of the faction folks. That is an interesting thing. Aaron Greenberg being there means that there's going to be some type of big marketing activation there. Aaron Greenberg does not miss an opportunity for marketing when it comes to Xbox Game Studios. So that was really cool to see. On the other side of marketing, it seems that Bethesda's really, really driven home the Starfield stories and tell your own stories and really explore, like, how you can exist in this universe and how people exist in this universe. So they released a animated anthology called The Settled Systems. So the first one was called Super Et Ultra, which was like a New Atlantis themed like anthology. Real short, couple minutes, very interesting seeing like a guy go from a delivery guy to one of the UC Vanguards. And, working his way up to being the captain's elite. Another one was Where Hope Was Built. This was like a person way out in the Free Star Collective in Kill City. And they wanted to be an explorer, but didn't have a ship. Eventually, they were gifted a ship and got to be an explorer. Really cool story, really heartwarming. It's like lit up that explorer flame in me. And I thought it was really cool. And then the other one was The Hand That Feeds. So this was really a story that took place in Neon City about these two people who were friends, and they were going to rob this guy. The other person stopped the robbery from happening and chose the moral high ground and, went with their heart and their gut and made the right decision and helped them end up in a better place. So it's really, really explored how, like, all these different areas in Starfield exist, how the real human element of the story is going to keep driving your interest in Starfield. I thought those were really cool. I appreciate it that Bethesda even did this, because I'm used to Bethesda just going radio silent and be like, all right, in 2 weeks we're dropping the game. So, like, that's the Bethesda I'm used to. A lot of people are just like, we're the marketing hype, blah, 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 marketing, marketing, marketing. I'm like, chill, buddy. I'm like, you must be new here because Bethesda doesn't play like that. Xbox does, but Bethesda doesn't. So it is what it is, in my opinion. I'm like, we got less than 30 days, you know, T-minus 29. And I think that Starfield is going to be a really fun time for everyone. And I hope that we all, like, go into it with realistic expectations. I've seen a lot of craziness out on the forums. But we have to understand, right? Starfield is a human story that focuses on you discovering relics, okay? That's, like, the main storyline. You discover relics. So don't expect any intelligent alien life, like, existing in the universe. There might be remnants of what was intelligent alien life. And then you eventually discover what happened to it, where they are, what part of the galaxy they're in, etc. But you're not going to run into, like, an intelligent alien faction. You know what I mean? So, you know, keep that level-headed. I've seen some people saying, like, oh, you know, what if we can... I wonder if we can build ships that can, like, act as a ship carrier, like an aircraft carrier, but for... in space. And I'm like, buddy, the ship design system wasn't built with that intent in mind. So... be level-headed here, because that is a very complex layered system that this person was talking about. Unrealistic for this game at this point in development, but, you know, good idea, but probably not going to happen. So temper your expectations. Another thing is people are looking for, they're thinking that Bethesda's going to add rideable alien creatures like they did in Skyrim. Definitely not going to be here at launch, and probably won't be around, be there at the Shattered Space expansion. So, like, let's be real, guys. That is a system of systems that has to be, like, tested extremely thoroughly, QA'd a lot, and before it's even certified, that is going to break a lot of systems in the game. If you guys like to travel a lot, just use a jump jet. So, you know. Though that's just my little 3-minute rant. You know, I don't want to hold you guys too much. I appreciate all the likes, subscriptions, follows, and I appreciate all the comments, man. The comments really keep me engaged, and, you know, I just appreciate you guys watching the video. I appreciate all of you guys who took the time out of your day, you know, to get this No BS Starfield update. Hey, I'll see you guys space side. Keep it real. Ian out.